Greetings, Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the Candida range of supplements. Thanks for checking out my video. I got a question from a man called Frank Yang from Los Angeles, and Frank's asking, Eric, pantothene, what is it? Is it good for Candida? So let's talk about what pantothene is. So pantothene is the active form of pantothenic acid, or vitamin B5. I should say vitamin B5. So there are many different types of B vitamins. In the old days, well, 10 years ago, that's the old days now, we had forms that were non-active. So they have to be converted by the liver into active forms in order for them to work. For example, if we look at vitamin B6, okay, pyridoxal hydrochloride was a typical vitamin B6 supplement that was used, well, when I grew up and all through my student years, pyridoxine was just used. It was normal to use. It's the same as B12. We've got better forms now. It's the same as B2 and B3. But now we've got active forms. So now we've got pyridoxal 5-phosphate instead of pyridoxine hydrochloride. It's a much better form. Now we've got pantothene instead of pantothenic acid. So B5 is notoriously hard for the body to get into the cell. So when they created pantothene, it's a much more easily absorbable form that can bypass liver and go to work directly on the cellular level. Okay, so it just works faster. So when I think of B5, I'm thinking about particularly fat and carbohydrate metabolism. So B5 is quite a good one for people to use who want to burn up some fat in their body. So it assists the cellular transport of fatty acids. So what it does is activates this stuff called carnitine. It helps carnitine, this amino acid, to get fatty acids into the mitochondria, which is the engine of the cell. So the intermitochondrial oxidation of fatty acids helps to burn fat. Are you still with me on this? Here's a simple one. Picture a guy with a wheelbarrow and he wants to get a pile of fat from here over to there. And he can't really do it because he's fat and lazy himself. So how's he going to get all the fat from there to there? He just gets a half a dozen friends over to help him. And they use better wheelbarrows, more efficient, nice plastic ones, pumped up tires. Now he's got three or four skinny friends, and all that fat can be moved from A to B very quickly. And that's what pantothene can do. It can move fat more efficiently from one place to another. So if you can imagine a guy with a wheelbarrow full of fat throwing it into a furnace, and what do the flames do? They get hotter and hotter and hotter, okay? So the fat metabolism works more efficiently with B5. That's a simple way to put it, isn't it? The other key thing with B5 is pantothene. It's very, very good, particularly for adrenal function. So B5 is one of the most important B vitamins to activate the production of adrenal stress hormones. Okay, so your adrenals have to make stress hormones like cortisol, many other hormones, but cortisol is one of the main ones. So cortisol production is very dependent on B5. B5 is also required to activate coenzyme A. Now, coenzyme A is what drives energy up in the body. Your body is very efficient. It's got multiple ways to create energy, but the coenzyme A pathway is superior. So when you give a person pantothene, they're going to produce more CoA and more efficiently convert fat and carbs to energy, much more efficiently. So it's a little bit like old engines, steam engines. Now we've got petrol engines, which are way more efficient. They give you more power. So if you want more energy, okay, if you want to burn more fat, if you want to have less stress and handle stress, B5, folks. A good dose of B5 can be anywhere between, I'd say, 300-400 up to about 1,000 milligrams per day. So it's good to play around with pantothene to see how you feel, and it might work quite well for you. Now, just be careful, because there are some websites that claim that pantothene actually is good for candida. It's a load of crap. It doesn't affect candida at all. I just looked at a very prominent candida website, and the author says that pantothene, in fact, is very important because it helps to remove acetaldehyde from the body, one of the byproducts from candida. This is nonsense. You go and look at yourself. Acetaldehyde, the studies that person's referring to, refer acetaldehyde production from alcohol consumption in people with fatty livers. So when you drink a lot of booze, you produce aldehyde, okay? Acetaldehyde is a byproduct. Your liver's got to mop and clean all that up. That gives you that brain foggy kind of feeling, you know, that, oh, Have you guys ever drunk a bottle of vodka or whiskey before? Well, I saw a lot of that in Las Vegas, people walking around drinking. When you drink alcohol, especially hard alcohol, your body produces acetaldehyde. The liver's got to break that down. Now, pantothenine has shown merit in that particular situation, but there is no scientific or clinical proof at all to show that acetaldehyde, as a spin-off from Candida, is possibly affected by pantothenine. So don't believe the hype. In fact, don't believe much of the stuff you read online. It's crap. Be careful what you read. You could die of a misprint. So I hope this video has been a bit of an eye-opener for you. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. You're going to get a lot more videos if you do. And please check out yeastinfection.org. If you haven't done my Candida quiz already, please do my Candida quiz. You'll find it on candida.com. You'll find it on yeastinfection.org. Check it out. Thank you.